Right now, a follow-up to an 11 News I-Team investigation. In May, we told you how Verizon customers were sometimes forced to wait weeks to get their landline phone service repaired.
And after that story aired, we continue to hear from consumers with similar complaints. But we also heard from Verizon technicians who are equally frustrated. I-Team reporter Mindy Becerra explains.
David Pitt says he was periodically without phone service at his northern Baltimore County home for 10 months, especially when it rained.
They continued to say that they couldn't get a service tech out for 2 to 3 weeks.
Verizon technicians finally pinpointed the problem in the phone line several miles away.
They discovered that it was not within our line. It was actually out on Whitehall Road.
David is just one of many Verizon customers frustrated over problems with their landline phone service. The technicians union says workers understand where customers are coming from.
My technicians on a daily basis are frustrated and embarrassed, quite honestly, that they're out trying to repair customers' lines that have been out of service for weeks on end.
Mark Balsamo is the president of Communications Workers of America, Local 2100. He was not surprised at all when he watched our report.
I need my phone to work. It doesn't work. Well, you need to call this number, but I don't have a phone.
And heard customers' horror stories of waiting weeks to get their phones fixed, some with no other access to 911.
What would Verizon be telling us now if he had a heart attack without a phone?
So what's the problem? Both Mark and this former Verizon technician who does not want to be identified say it's all about cutting costs.
They are concentrating mainly on budget issues and not so much on customer service.
According to the technicians union, here's what's happening. When a customer reports a problem with their phone line, a computer system nicknamed the scrubber tests the line. If the problem is resolved and no technician is needed, it's supposed to call the customer to confirm.
A lot of times, from what my technicians tell me and I know for a fact, is that that customer never receives that call. So they're sitting home all day long waiting for the technician to come. Nobody shows up. And then when they call back in to find out what happened, the trouble's gone. It's been closed out.
Even though the problem hasn't been fixed.
Now it seems, it seemed for a while that, you know, a lot of people get scrubbed no matter what. You know, they just get scrubbed. Their job gets closed out in the computer system before it ever gets handled by a human being. From what I understand, it counts as a closed ticket. It counts as a fixed, a repaired line.
Verizon declined our request for an on-camera interview, but a company spokesperson admits that sometimes tickets are closed when a customer can't be reached after repeated attempts by its automated system.
Closing tickets is important. According to a recent settlement with Maryland's Public Service Commission, Verizon needs to close out those tickets, repair the residential landlines within 48 hours, 80% of the time, or face fines to the tune of $6 million. The union president says for a multi-billion dollar company,
that's like me and you, Mindy, finding a nickel in a couch. I mean, it is not any type of deterrent at all for Verizon.
Balsamo says there are not enough technicians to handle the workload and believes that problem is only going to get worse. Verizon plans on cutting its nationwide workforce by 12,000 through attrition and buyouts, and Balsamo believes layoffs. And the union is concerned the company plans on getting out of the copper landline business altogether.
Clearly, Verizon's taken an approach that they want to be a wireless, I believe, non-union company around here, and, you know, they may not say it on camera. I don't believe they care.
Meanwhile, Verizon customer David Pitts is crossing his fingers every time he picks up the phone.
As far as we know, they have fixed it properly, but that's 4 miles down the road, and the transfer station is 5 to 6 miles away from the house. So there's the possibility of it going bad again.
Verizon says its employees are focused on delivering high-quality service to all of its customers. The company goes on to say, we spend several million dollars a day on our landline infrastructure in Maryland to ensure our customers' experience is positive. In regard to jobs, the company says we will be required to reduce our workforce in various landline-focused departments this year. These reductions are not specific to any geographic area and will be accomplished by voluntary means to the extent possible. If you're having problems with your Verizon landline service, the Maryland Public Service Commission wants to hear from you. There's a link on our website, WBALTV.com. Just click on I-Team. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Mindy Becerra.